Shi Mengwei Lioness and her daughter have been doing great. They were seen on a few occasions in northwestern Sabi Sands. So far, Shi Mengwei has managed to take great care of her daughter, who's now a year and a half old. In May of this year, the Ottawa male met his fate when he was reportedly caught by the Birmingham males during one of his expeditions. He was descending upon Birmingham territory for months, often hardly fleeing, but on that disastrous night, he wasn't so fortunate. His remains were found by the rangers. Carcass still had its head and claws intact, which rules out the possibility of him being poached. The passing of the Ottawa male immediately put his Mengani pride and cubs in the line of fire. Within a few weeks of his death, the duo of Styx and Inkahuma males arrived under the cover of darkness, but were successfully chased off by the Mengani pride. This, however, is not going to last very long, as sooner or later, newcomers will find enough assurance and courage to take over, which will inevitably cause difficulties for the unprotected pride. The Ottawa pride is flourishing with their six cubs in the Deep West. Cubs are fathered by the reigning Tumbela Coalition. Tumbela males entered the western sector last year and managed to push the old Matimba male out to secure control over the Ottawa pride. They were looking very promising, but as of recently, things are going tough for the coalition. One of them is not in good condition. One female and three sub-adults of the Ottawa pride have formed a nomadic pride, and they have been doing well for the past few months. They are very good at hunting, which is why they are almost always in reasonable condition. They moved out of the western sector and lingered in Sabi Sabi for a few days before once again turning back west. For now, they're doing okay, but things will get worse for the female sub-adult if she doesn't return to the pride. Dark-maned northern Avoca, as usual, spent almost all of his time with the Talamati pride, wandering in and out of the Sabi Sands Game Reserve. Sub-adults of the Talamati pride are learning to hunt under the guidance of the pride females. The constant presence of their father has boosted their chances of becoming successful in the future, and things are looking very promising for them. While Darkmane is involved with the Talamatis, his brothers, Blondie and Mohawk, have constantly been jabbing into the Birmingham-controlled region. Both coalitions have persisted in very close vicinity to each other for the past few months, and on more than one occasion, they have stalked each other. The fact that they have been invading and vocalizing for the past few months verifies that the Avocas are willing to engage with the veteran coalition. The Birminghams, on the other hand, can't be underestimated, as the killing of the Ottawa male is clear evidence of what the veterans are skilled at executing. For now, both coalitions are carrying their own, but a severe conflict seems unavoidable. Sub-adults of the Kambula pride can be acknowledged as nomads, as they are on their own for the past couple months. Their mothers have new cubs to take care of, and they can no longer afford to have sub-adults with them. The young lions have been seen moving all over the south-central Sabi Sands. They are wandering and hunting on their own, which puts them in considerable threat. What the future carries for them is sure to be seen. Southern Sabi Sands is the home of the most promising coalition of the whole reserve. All four Inwazwashaka brothers are holding sharp. When the four sub-adults of the Ottawa pride entered their territory, they rapidly chased them out. Inwazwashakas are dominant over the Southern and Styx pride, and they have fathered cubs with both prides. These cubs have the best opportunity of making it to adulthood, as Inwashakas are there to defend them from any rival males, and their mothers are undoubtedly great huntresses. Southern Avocas, as usual, mainly stayed in Kruger with one of their prides. They made brief appearances, but quickly returned into the Kruger. They are dominant over the Sand River and the Plains Camp Pride, which were abandoned by the Mantamal males back in late 2019. Two Plains Camp young males are also moving through the whole reserve for the past few months. They were discovered in northern Sabi Sands before turning south, where they briefly met Inkahuma and Styx. Both duos went on their ways after a short period. The latest sighting of the Plains Camp males was documented from the western sector, where they were seen roaring. What their next move is yet to be understood. Will they join Styx and Inkahuma on the quest for dominance, or they'll decide to challenge the Tumbelas? Or will they choose a completely different alternative? Only time will answer the questions.